Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to review the if statement and show how to use a nested if statement. If you've ever been in the situation where you need to use more than one if statement in a formula, then this is the tutorial for you. So today, we are going to first review the if statement and the arguments that it takes, and then we are going to use a nested if statement as part of a VLOOKUP function. In Excel, the if function uses three arguments. The first argument is the logical test. The second argument is the value if the logical test is true. And the third argument is the value if the logical test is false. So in other words, if something is true, then return this value. Otherwise, return this value. So I've created a spreadsheet here, and what this spreadsheet includes are salesmen for a paper sales company and their quarterly sales. So across the top in row one, I have the quarter, and in column A, I have the salesmen. I also have in row two, the best salesman of that quarter. If you look in each one of those cells, you will see this formula up here where it's just a max formula of all of the cells that lie below it. And I have that set up for each quarter. I would just like to get my best salesman per quarter. My function arguments are going to change based on which quarter I put in J8. So if I want to be able to return the name of the salesman, not only does my table array change, but also my column index number that I'm going to return with this VLOOKUP function will change as well. So I'm going to need a nested if statement here. Now let's go over the if function. The if function looks like this. If I type in a cell and I type equals if and a left parenthesis, the first argument I'm being asked for is a logical test. What am I evaluating? I would like to evaluate which function I'm going to use based on which quarter I have entered right here in this cell J8. So in this case, I'm going to say my logical test is if this cell equals, and put this in double quotes because it's text, Q1, close the quote and hit a comma. If that cell equals Q1, then which VLOOKUP function do I want to use? I'm going to look over here to the right, and I want to use VLOOKUP left parenthesis, the sales number, comma, the table array of B3 to F11, comma, and then I want to return the fifth column, comma, and I want the last argument to be false. So in this case, if I've selected quarter one, then my table array for VLOOKUP starts in column B, and I return column 5. So I'm going to leave that VLOOKUP function in, and I'm going to type a comma. And then what value do I want to return here if I have not put in quarter one? For now, I'm just going to put false, and I'm going to hit enter. So is this true? Is the salesman that sold $187,000 in quarter one Dwight? Yes, it is. But what happens if I switch this to quarter two? Now I'm getting an error because I have not accounted for quarter two yet. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to get notifications of our new weekly Excel tips. Quarter two's VLOOKUP function is going to look like this over here. So I'm going to copy the VLOOKUP function that starts quarter two's table array at column C, and it returns the fourth column. So I'm going to copy that function, and I'm going to come over here where the value is false, and I'm just going to type over that word false, and I'm going to do another if statement. This if statement is within another if statement. So this is called a nested if statement. So right here, I'm going to type if with a left parenthesis. What is my logical test? My logical test, again, is the value right here in J8 is equal to, this time, quarter 2. Close that quote and type a comma. What is the function I want to return if it's quarter 2? The one I just pasted, where my table array starts at C3 and it returns column 4. And then I'm still within the if statement, so I can't forget to do a comma, and I'm going to return the word false if this is false, and then I have to close that parenthesis. That is very, very important. So I'm going to hit enter in this case. So now, if I change this to Q1, I'm returning Dwight for Q1, which is correct. If I change this to Q2, I am going to return Pam for Q2, which is correct. However, if I go up here and I do Q3, I have not accounted for Q3 yet. So what's different about Q3? In Q3, my VLOOKUP function is going to start on column D, and I'm going to return the third column in my table array. I've already written that if statement over here. I'm going to copy it. And when I look in my little nest up here, this last false argument is all I need to replace to put my new nested if statement. So I'm just going to paste that in there, put a right parenthesis, and hit enter. So now that is also working for Q3. So let's look at this formula one more time. I still have a false in there, and that's because I have not put the VLOOKUP formula yet for Q4. So watch, when I type in Q4, I'm still being returned with this false right here. I'm going to make the assumption that if it's not Q1, Q2, or Q3, that the user has entered Q4. This is the final part of my if statement. And over here, I've written the VLOOKUP for when it's quarter 4. So I'm going to copy that one. It has the table array going from E3 to F11, and I'm returning column 2. So finally, I'm going to go into my little nested if, and instead of returning with a false, I'm just going to highlight that and paste the VLOOKUP function that I have for the case else, which is column 4, and I'm going to hit enter. And in this case, for Q4, I will be returned with Stanley. Is that correct? Yes, it is. Now, nested if statements can be very, very complicated, and it's very easy to get lost. So what I always recommend is building those one step at a time and always replacing the false argument in the first if statement with your next whole if statement. And work on it piece by piece, and you should be able to not get lost in all of the parentheses. So in review today, we went over the if statement and its arguments, and then we showed how to use an if statement inside of an if statement inside of an if statement inside of an if statement, also known as a nested if statement. Thanks for joining us today, and look forward to seeing you next time.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.